Hello everyone, this is Major Jip, and today it's just going to be a quick video on the Sony DT-30 digital timer. I believe, from what I've seen online, this is part of a whole Betamax kit. This is the timer portion of it. I definitely could be wrong about that, but that's all I could find about this thing online. Betamax, of course, is the Sony's alternative to VHS's when they first came out. I also have a Betamax tape. Don't have a Betamax player, though. So, just found this at a thrift store for a couple bucks. And this I bought at a flea market for a couple of dollars, too. I mean, just as it is now, it's a pretty neat-looking clock, I suppose. But it does have a few interesting aspects to it. For one, it on the back of it, this doesn't have any sort of alarm or sound-making device or anything built into it. Focus. Okay. But what it does have is a power pass-through. I believe this is the power pass-through, and this is the one that's controlled by the timer. So you can attach a, say, a more analog radio. As you can see, it flips the, it's more of a turn dial type clock as opposed to a flip clock. I believe this is sort of the technology that came after flip. It's also backlit. If I pull the lights, which I will do, you can see it's backlit. There's probably two lights at one point, but one of them burned out, so it's just lit up right around here and there and dims out there. As you can see, it's taken some pretty good abuse over the years. I actually bought this. I believe I spent $5 on this thing in a local flea market. And the guy had no idea what it was, really. Just sold it as a clock, which, for all intents and purposes, I'm not even sure. It could have just been a clock that controlled another unit. I could very easily have looked at things not relating to this. I did find one listing on eBay, and it was bidded up to like $70 or $80. I'm not sure what to make of that last time I checked. So how do you use this thing? Well, at the moment it's set to the correct time, because what better time to record a video than 1:10 in the morning? One interesting thing is it has the timer on the left here, and that corresponds to the time it will power the switched plug at the back. And you turn that on there, and it has a little light on it. At the moment it's set for 1, so it's not going to set properly. You have to go this way. I suppose it would be counterclockwise. And we'll say set it for 1. And then it went off. You heard that click. That would have put power on if I had the timer set, but of course I didn't. Forgot to turn it on. So that's brilliant. And that's when it'll go off. It'll go off a few hours after it goes on. I suppose that's in case. As you can see, it's still powered. And then a few hours later, it'll go off completely, which is a nice feature, I suppose. But that's not all. I suppose we should see this thing working in action. And considering it's already gone on to 4-something minutes. I'm sorry if this is a little long-winded. This is just a quick video. I'm not too certain as to what this is. I just thought I'd really demonstrate it because it's pretty neat. I mean, I just use this thing as a normal clock, and that's basically it. I use it as a normal clock because it looks pretty neat. And in the dark, it does actually look pretty well backlit, which I suppose I will show you now. And as you can see, it's backlit. You can see up to the 2 in You know, plain human eyesight. Let's see, it's lit up a little bit in the counter in the back. Not much. Also, this light's the brightest. I suppose that's because the timer probably wasn't used all that much. And that little light lights up the timer display, and you just set that with the wheel going counterclockwise. So we can set it for
AM
has, and there it goes. And it clicked, so it put power on the plug, and then a couple hours later, turns itself off completely, and the timer will. Actually, I believe the timer will stay set for the next. No, it won't. You have to reset it with that. You could also turn it off manually, and you have the. Should probably turn on the light for this. And you have the dial here that you can turn left to turn it on all the way. But whilst that's all well and good, why don't I find something to plug into it and show you how it powers something on and off? I shall return. Okay, and this is just going to be a quick demonstration of it powering one of the most basic table radios you could possibly find, really. Some of the basic circuitry ever. I'll probably make a video on this, because this is actually kind of unsafe. Instead of this radio using a step-down transformer, it uses a big resistor just mounted onto the plastic casing, or suspended very close to the plastic casing. So it melted the plastic casing because it got a little bit too close, which I would imagine caused some smoking of some sort. Anyway, one thing good about something like this is it only has a couple of electronic parts and never breaks, as I've never done anything to really fix this radio. Getting off topic, as you can see, this is plugged into the switched port on the back of the Sony radio. And the wire just sort of runs over here. Good enough. And you just go. You can turn it on manually, like I said. And I believe I have this tuned to the public access. I don't know, the local radio station that plays classical music, basically. To help to not be picked up by YouTube's insane filters that'll pick up like 2 seconds of a song and flag it as not fun. So, as you can see, this switch controls this plug. And it appears that I'm running out of battery life, so jump cut. Alright, quick intermission as I had to plug in the camcorder. Anyway, back to this. Actually, it's probably not going to be an intermission video. Anyway, I've showed this 1,000 times, but yes. It's obviously controlling that stereo back there. Radio back there. So now you flip it to timer. Set. Turn this counterclockwise. If you don't, it'll lock up and won't work right. And we'll just leave it set to probably about 130, 145. And as you just saw, it kicked on at exactly 130. You'll probably also notice that by the 1 from 9 to 0, it has that little Japan on the screen, which is pretty neat. Shows where it's made. It's obviously made in Japan, being a Sony product of, I suppose, 80s, give or take? Give or take, I have no idea. And Then I suppose I will just zoom through a couple of hours and show you that it will eventually turn off. Either that or I was completely wrong. Okay, so after a good amount of time, what was that, like 4 or 5 hours? Well, 1:30 to 6 o'clock, 4 and a half. Yes. It will turn itself off, which I suppose isn't that bad. And as you can see, you just changed the time with the left. Anyway, that's all that I really have left to say about that. Well, let me just let you get a good look at that screen one last time. Well, I say screen. It's not really a screen. And yeah, it has a bunch of dents. But there's the model number, Sony Digital Timer DT-30. May or may not have come with some Betamax player. I really have no idea. Nor have I really taken that much time to figure it out. Well, I think that about does it with this Sony DT-30. Any questions? If you have any questions about this unit, or if you have any information to tell me about this unit, would be far more useful. Just you can give me a comment or a personal message, if YouTube is even still doing that anymore. I don't know, with all this changing to Google+. Anyway, that's about it. Thanks for watching. Major Jip, signing out.